Okay. Hello, hello. This is another check-in in the garden. My wife's pentagon's working out beautifully. I don't see any beans in there. I'll put some more beans in there and see if it could catch. So we really like them to grow together. For them to work together. See, the beans are working really well over here. They sprouted really nice. I've been keeping them watered. And I've watered them at night too. Lettuce. I think there's something coming out. We'll see. One step at a time. Here's the garlic. Garlic's working out. Beautiful. Doing sideways. This one. Gotta keep an eye on this one. There we go. And see, some of the beans is already coming out of there. Parsley, tiny parsley. It's leaning down on the job, but it's doing well. It's nice and rich and green. I need my vitamin D and vitamin C. So, it's the one thing that's really good about that. You can eat it and get vitamin C right away. And that's parsley also. It's chives. Didn't realize it was that small, that thin. It's cool. And these will grow year round. I planted them last year. And they stuck. Awesome. If that's grass, that's grass. I can pull it out later. Thank you. Here's le potato, le potato, the plant, anyways, growing rich and green, gorgeous. I gotta get the greenhouse here so I can have it year round. It's just I need that extra light as well. Cutest little mushroom. That's awesome. That's adorable. Take a look at the onion. Yeah. And hopefully this is, well, I'm hoping it is, strawberry. I've got a whole bunch of strawberry ends and I put them, with seeds. Seeds are on the strawberry, are on the outside, so. I took the ends of leftovers and I just planted them. And like I said, hopefully it catches. There's the other one over just behind the parsley here. And that's the other one right there. We'll see. But look how healthy it is. Lots better. It's just watering constantly. And here's my second mistake. It seems to be forgiving me. I'm happy. And yeah, look what's coming out. Yeah. Corn and sunflower seeds. And this has got a lot of, this is, has a lot of, what you call it, a lot of fertilizer in there, a lot of kitty poo-poo. But it's been there for a long time, so hopefully thoroughly composted. Yeah, I need more information on what to do with the compost, because buying kitty litter and buying kitty litter all the time. That's why, yeah, that's why I want to leave to get that enclosed, and that's enclosed. And then kitty, little baby kitty, my little queen, will have lots of room everywhere. Fresh kitty litter. And all I have to do is just figure out how to use it, utilize it in the garden. But definitely in a compost area, for sure. And then, 6 minutes in, check this out. She's growing gorgeous. I'll be taking some pictures and posting them online as well. There we go. Light it up. Let's see if I can get it nice and clear. Yeah, please. There we go. Beautiful. Hello. Okay, 7 minutes in and 15 seconds. Yeah. I'll be pruning these away and then actually using them for sticks to make a little cage. No birdies to show you, but they've been coming, jumping on the roof over there and just snatching away their meal and then running away. Yeah. They trust me a little more, but, see, they live right there. They have a family there. There we go. There they are. Hi. Yeah, they're keeping an eye on me. Anyways, all good today. Yeah, it's really nice. The thing is, when you have a mix, a variety of everything growing together, everything, you know, kind of work, balances, works in an equilibrium, one feeds the other. It's like beans as nitrogen, as a legume, right? It's a nitrogen fixator. So that helps other plants to bloom, to get nurtured and grow. Oh, she's raining today. Good. Minutes and 30 seconds. Okie dokie, this will be posted online as well on YouTube.